knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
For some time, we have been discussing fungi within the phylum Basidiomycota, the club fungi. Within this phylum, let us now move further into the class Agaricomycetes, which consists of many of the mushroom-forming species of fungi, and more specifically, the order Agaricales, which consists of many of the gilled mushroom species. In this tutorial, we will be introducing a number of new types of these fungi, including the families Cortinariaceae, Nidulariaceae, and Psathyrellaceae, along with the genera Conocybe and Laccaria. Let's begin by discussing the Cortinariaceae family. Generally, this family describes fungi in the genus Cortinarius, which is the largest genus of mushroom-forming species, estimated to have over 2,000 species worldwide. The notable structural characteristic of this genus is the presence of a cortina, a web-like partial veil that covers the gills of the mushroom when young. As the mushroom ages, the remnants of the cortina may form a ring on the stipe or along the margin of the cap. The gills produce a rusty brown spore print, so the gills of Cortinarius mushrooms are generally rusty brown as well. These mushrooms are not purely saprobic, so throughout their life cycle, they do not always need to break down organic matter to survive. Instead, they form mutually benefiting relationships called mycorrhiza, myco meaning fungi, and rhiza meaning root. So mycorrhizal relationships form between fungi and plant roots. A number of fungi form mycorrhizal relationships of different types. However, when fungi in the phylum Basidiomycota form mycorrhiza, they specifically form ectomycorrhiza. Structurally, ectomycorrhiza have the root system completely surrounded by a layer of hyphae called a mantle. Some of the hyphae penetrate the outer layer of the root, forming a network called the Hartig net. The Hartig net allows the fungus and the plant to become closely connected, allowing for the exchange of nutrients such as sugars, nitrogen-containing compounds, and amino acids. Many other mushroom genera we will discuss throughout this series form ectomycorrhizal relationships. Our next family is quite fascinating. This is Nidulariaceae, commonly known as the bird's nest fungi, because their fruiting bodies look like tiny egg-filled bird's nests. The name comes from the Latin root nidus, meaning nest. These fungi are saprobic on decaying wood, so you are likely to find these adorable fruiting bodies on wood chips or mulch. Fungi in the family Nidulariaceae have unique structures. We previously discussed the gasteroid puffballs of Agaricaceae. Bird's nest fungi are also gasteroid because they develop their spores inside those small egg-like structures called peridioles. These peridioles have their basidia and basidiospores surrounded by a hardened wall. The nest-like structure that houses the peridioles is called the peridia. All bird's nest fungi have an interesting method of dispersing their peridioles, and therefore their spores. The nest-like peridia act as splash cups. When a raindrop hits the peridia slightly off-center, the raindrop expels the peridioles up to a meter away. Two out of the five genera in the family possess tendrils called funiculi that are attached to the peridioles. When the peridioles are expelled from the peridia, the funiculi can wrap around a plant nearby. It is hypothesized that herbivores will eat the plant and the attached peridiole, assisting in further spore dispersal. Now let us move to a family that has the general structure of a gilled mushroom with a cap, gills, and a stipe, the family Psathyrellaceae. We will discuss three genera in this family, Coprinellus, Coprinopsis, and Psathyrella. Fungi in Psathyrellaceae are almost always saprobic. You can find these fungi on soil, dung, decaying wood, and many other substrates. The fruiting bodies are generally small and fragile with dark-colored spores. Let's begin our discussion of Psathyrellaceae by discussing the similar genera Coprinellus and Coprinopsis, commonly known as the ink caps. The common name originates from a unique property of these mushrooms. As they age, the gills partially liquefy, or deliquesce, into a black, goopy, and ink-like substance. This process is already quite captivating, but it is another demonstration of the genius of evolution. The caps of these mushrooms liquefy from the edges in, so the maturing spores at the inner parts of the cap are in prime position to catch wind currents to disperse. Identification on the species level is quite difficult for two reasons. The first is that these mushrooms are extremely fragile and ephemeral. Over a single day, some species will fruit, deliquesce, and reduce to almost nothing, so it is quite difficult to gather the mushrooms as specimens. Second, the separation of Copranopsis and Copranella species may require microscopic and genetic analysis. Copranopsis atramentaria, or the common ink cap, is known to be edible, but contains a molecule called coprine that causes poisoning when consumed within a 2 to 3 day time period of drinking any form of alcohol. This has caused some confusion with Coprinus comatus, the shaggy mane mushroom we discussed in the Agaricaceae lecture. This mushroom does not contain coprine and does not lead to alcohol-induced poisonings. Our next genus in the family Psathyrellaceae is Psathyrella, commonly called the brittle stems. These mushrooms are small and fragile. They produce black to brown spores and do not liquefy like the aforementioned genera. The stipes are whitish to yellow and hollow on the inside, allowing them to have a satisfying snap. The caps are generally brown and oftentimes hygrophonous, meaning the caps change color as they lose moisture. Identification on the species level generally requires microscopy. In Haitian tradition, species of Psathyrella are highly valued as a delicacy. Called djon-djon, the caps of these mushrooms are served at important events such as baptisms and weddings. Djon-djon is generally boiled and strained. The djon-djon water is used to flavor cooked rice. Because these mushrooms can be quite expensive and rare, djon-djon flavored bouillon cubes are commonly used as a replacement for these dishes. Now we will move away from Psathyrellaceae to discuss the genus Conocybe, commonly known as the dunce caps due to their conical or bell-shaped caps. They are small, fragile, usually brown mushrooms that are saprobic on grass and other substrates. A common species of Conocybe is Conocybe apala, a mushroom that notably fruits in grass lawns. The mushroom is toxic, but not lethal, so keep your pets and children away. It has a pale brown color, and you will find the mushroom when the weather is hot and humid. The last genus we will discuss is Laccaria. These mushrooms are easy to recognize as they have thick and waxy-looking gills that are attached to the stipe. They form white spore prints, and under a microscope, these spores are round with tiny spine-like projections. All Laccaria species form ectomycorrhizal relationships that are generally associated with tree roots in the order Phagales, which houses oak and beech trees. A notable species in the genus is Laccaria amethystina, or the amethyst deceiver. The name originates from difficulties in identification of the mushroom because the bright purple coloring fades with age. Let us now move forward and continue to examine still more species within Agaricales.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.